Good morning to viewers. This is Srinivas, Department of Biology. My channel, Bio Srinivas channel. Today, I am going to explain the first topic in the 10th class syllabus of Telangana state. You know, the first lesson in the biology of 10th class is nothing but nutrition. In this nutrition, now I am going to explain the important experiment which was carried by a famous scientist named as Priestley. Priestley was the famous scientist in the 18th century who was conducted so many experiments on the influence of air, or we can say the importance of air in the process of photosynthesis. You know what is photosynthesis? Since your lower class onwards, you might have come across the word photosynthesis, which can be defined as the photochemical reaction in which there is a utilization of carbon dioxide, water in presence of sunlight and chlorophyll pigments, formation of glucose along with water and oxygen, the oxygen liberated into the atmosphere. That type of process is called photosynthesis. So, how the photosynthesis is dependent on the air which is available in the environment? On this aspect, the famous scientist in 18th century named as Priestley was conducted so many experiments, in that one experiment is very famous, that is called Bell-Jar experiment. The Bell-Jar experiment is very famous. Then in this Bell-Jar experiment, what he proved? After conducting the Bell-Jar experiment, he proved and made a statement that what the animals are releasing the waste gas into the atmosphere is absorbed by the plants and made the atmosphere into pure condition. Once again, I am repeating the statement proposed by the Priestley after Bell-Jar experiment is that what the animals are releasing the waste gas, that is absorbed by the plants and making the air pure in condition. That was the overall information and universal statement given by Priestley after conducting the Bell-Jar experiment. Yeah, the experiment conducted by Priestley named as Bell-Jar experiment, the aim, because to conduct one experiment in a scientific order, we need six steps. In the first step is aim. In this aim, we are going to prove that air is essential for photosynthesis process. Second side heading, what we are going to write here, it is the apparatus. Because to conduct any experiment in the biology, we need certain apparatus. Apparatus means what? The instruments which are used in the experiment. What are they? Bell-Jar, one candle, mouse, small mint plant, matchbox, and a table. These are the requirements for the Bell-Jar experiment what Priestley conducted. then procedure what to do and how to do this experiment. Let us see the procedure process along with the diagram, because diagram is very essential for understanding the biology in a easy manner. Procedure. In this procedure, what we should take? One table. On the table, take one candle and having this is a candle. What we place it on the table. Imagine this is the table. The rough diagram of the table. Five pad table, imagine. And this is a candle with a wick. Take the matchbox and light the matchstick such that it can glow. It's glowing. Which one is glowing? The candle is glowing. Then slowly with care take one big wide mouthed bell jar and put on the candle in this fashion such that the air should not enter inside, from outside to inside and inside to outside. This is the first stage in our experiment. Stage or step one. Then the priestly waited for 5 to 10 minutes. 5 to 10 minutes he waited. And after that, what happened? The candle was put off. The candle was put off. Suddenly, after 5 to 10 minutes, candle was put off. Now there is no light, only wick is available. Then step 2. Step 1 is over. Step 2. He introduced one mouse, very small mouse. Of course, this is a rough diagram of a mouse having the which is introduced by removing the bell jar, and candle is as easily fixed on the table, and just he removed the bell jar and introduced one mouse into the near the candle, and immediately he fixed the bell jar such that the mouse should not escape from the bell jar. That was the second step what he arranged here in the experiment. Then again, before putting this bell jar, he again lighted the candle. Now the candle is lighting, and at the same time he introduced the mouse and put the bell jar clearly as mentioned in the figure in the step 2. Then what happened? This is the step 1 result. Next, step 2. Now he waited up to 10 minutes. He observed द कैंडल वाज पुट ऑफ, कैंडल वाज पुट ऑफ. देन अगेन स्टिल ही इज वेटिंग टू ऑब्जर्व द मूवमेंट ऑफ द माउस विथ इन द बेल जार. After 30 to 45 minutes duration, the mouse is suffocating such that it is behaving in a different manner and trying to absorb or inhale certain gas into its body. That was the observation understood by the Priestley in his experiment in the step 2. Then 45 minutes completed. After that 45 minutes time period, the mouse was died. The mouse was died after a suffocation. Suffocation means lack of some gas which is required for its survival was not available. So in that way it is suffocating, and after 45 minutes time period, the mouse was died. What are the observations in the step 2? First one, when the candle was lighted and the mouse was introduced, immediately the bell jar was put out. On these two, after 10 minutes time period, candle was put off. Second observation, what? Up to 30 minutes the mouse was roaming around within the bell jar. And after 45 minutes time period, it is suffocating, afterwards it was dead. These are the observations what we can see in the step number 2. The next step 3. Step 3. In the step 3, in the step 2, the candle was put off. And this was died. In the step 2, the candle was put off and within 10 minutes time period, and after 30-45 minutes time period, the mouse was died in this way. The next step 3, what is written here, step 3. In this step 3, you remove the died mouse by removing which one? The bell jar. Now you remove the dead mouse by removing bell jar. Now you remove the dead mouse. Okay, now again you light the candle by removing the bell jar, because when the bell jar is present around and over the candle, we cannot light the candle. So like this. Okay, now the candle is lighted, and one more living mouse. Is introduced, and along with this one small potted mint plant which is healthy in condition is also introduced in this experiment. This rat, this mouse we should catch, otherwise it will run away from the table. That's why we should catch it. And when this mint plant kept beside to the candle, which is lighted with a matchstick and the mouse which we hold it properly, then immediately what to do? Immediately we have to put the bell jar such that it can cover these three items. Which can cover these three items. Which items? One is the living mouse, the other one is the small mint plant, the other one is the candle which is lighting. This is the step number 3. These are the arrangements what Priestley done in his experiment. Then he is waiting in step 3. First 10 minutes he observed. First 10 minutes. What he observed? The mouse was not died. In 10 minutes, mouse lived in condition. 30 to 45 minutes, mouse, sorry, here it is not mouse, it is a candle. Candle lighting. Candle lighting. In 30 to 45 minutes, mouse living in condition. And plant is also looking normally. Such that there is no wilting of leaves or there is no infolding of leaves. In previous place, in step 1 and step 2, what the changes we observed are not observed in the step 3. That was the amazing factor for the Priestley. Then this total apparatus from step 1 onwards, it is under sunlight. Here you can imagine sunlight. Which stage onwards? Step 1 onwards, it is under sunlight. Then why this happened? The mouse is living in condition. The candle is glowing. The mint plant leaves are not wilted and vali poledu. And not infolded, mudchukoni poledu. And the plant is not dried up, endi poledu. Why this are looking very normal? That was the doubt poking his mind. Whose mind? Priestley mind. Then he found a solution for these questions. The gas which is produced due to burning of wick is named as carbon dioxide. When a substance is burnt out in oxygen, which is available in the bell jar. So they are producing what? Carbon dioxide. And here the mouse is absorbing oxygen and the candle is also absorbing oxygen which is available within the bell jar. Candle is absorbing for its burning, mouse is absorbing for its respiration and they are releasing carbon dioxide. These two carbon dioxides are absorbed by whom? These two carbon dioxides are absorbed by the mint plant. These two carbon dioxides are absorbed by mint plant. In turn, it is performing photosynthesis because sunlight is available, carbon dioxide is available, water is present in the mint plant. And chloroplast also present in the leaf of the mint plant and they are releasing oxygen. So this oxygen is absorbed and utilized for the lighting of the candle and for the respiration of the mouse and these two are liberating carbon dioxide gases and these carbon dioxide gases are absorbed by the mint plant and it is performing the process called photosynthesis. So, for the process of photosynthesis, there are two phenomena are carried. One is the absorption of carbon dioxide and second one is the liberation of oxygen. That was proved lateral in the experiment of Priestley. This Priestley experiment is popularly called as Beljan experiment. Then what are the precautions? First precaution what we can take here, take the care such that first you should light the candle with a matchstick, then put the bell jar in step 1. In the step 2, you enlay the candle by removing the bell jar and introduce one mouse with your hand, then immediately you fix the bell jar such that the mouse should not go away from bell jar. Third one, introduce the mouse which is living one, the second mouse, because first mouse was dead. Then one small mint plant such that it can adjust into the size of the bell jar. These are the three precautions should be taken while conducting the Priestley bell jar experiment. Then we can understand that there are two phenomena are going on in photosynthesis. One is the absorption of carbon dioxide by the plants and release of oxygen by the plants, which are used for the burning of candle and respiration of the mouse. So after doing this entire bell jar experiment, Priestley concluded. What he concluded? He concluded that the animals, what they are polluting the environment by releasing certain gases, are purified by the plants. That was the statement given by Priestley after his experiment. What statement he given? What the animals are polluting the environment by releasing certain gases are purified by the plants by absorbing them. That was the statement given by the Priestley after doing bell jar experiment. In this, how many steps are involving? There are three steps are involving. And the gas which is used for the burning of substances is discovered by Priestley. But the name is coined by Lavoisier. Lavoisier coined name of the combustible gas as oxygen. What the Lavoisier coined the name of combustible gas as oxygen. So oxygen was discovered by Priestley and the name was given by Lavoisier. These are the two scientists who are very important in the exchange of gases by the plants. Plants also contain the respiratory structures called stomata that we will discuss in the coming classes. If you like this video, please share and please subscribe into my channel called as Bio Srinivas channel in YouTube. Thank you very much. Have a nice day. Stay at home. Stay safe.